Chapter 2 National Income Accounting. In this chapter, we need to study some basic concept of macroeconomics. We know what is GDP, what is national income. In this chapter, we are studying how we can calculate national income and GDP, like these things we can study in this chapter. Okay. We know through GDP, we can calculate our welfare, or it is a indicator of welfare of a country. Okay. Then we know who is the father of economics. Adam Smith is the father of economics. In his most famous work, An Enquiry into the Nature and Cause of Wealth of Nations, in that book he described about the wealth of nations. Okay. How we can achieve economic wealth and how we can achieve growth, these things he described in his books. Okay, let us study about this basic concept, some basic concept like what is goods, what is consumer goods, what is finished goods, these things we can study. Okay. First, we can study what is goods. In economics, a good is defined as a physical object, man-made, or that could command a price in the market, and these are the materials that satisfy human wants and provide utility. Means, in economics, goods are defined as a physical object, man-made, and that could command price. Means goods means that should have a price. Okay, then that goods have the capacity to satisfy human wants and provide utility, means some use will be there. Okay, that one we are calling as goods. Okay, goods also different types of goods are there: consumption goods, capital goods, intermediate goods, final goods, like that different goods are there. We can go through that and which are the different types of goods. Okay, we know final goods means, we know in a production different stages are there. Final goods means goods, those goods which are used either for final consumption or for investment, means using for final consumption, that goods we are calling as final goods. Okay, then consumption goods means those final goods which satisfy human wants directly, means we know want satisfying capacity of a goods we are calling as utility. Okay, means like that, if a good have by using that good we are getting satisfaction, means that one is consumption goods. Okay, example ice cream, milk, cloth, like that all items we can call as consumption goods. Okay, then different types of consumption goods are there. In consumption goods also final goods are there, intermediate goods are there. Suppose a farmer producing cotton and he is selling to spinning mill, where that one is transforming to yarn, and this yarn turn to cloth or something else. Okay, that one, then that cotton we can call it as intermediate goods. Okay, suppose if final product is cloth, okay, dress material or dress, then that one is final goods and this cotton is intermediate goods. Okay, like that we know in our economy different services are there. Okay, different services like doctor service, lawyer service, financial consultation, banking service, like that different services are there. Then we know different products are there, like machineries are there, automobiles are there, aeroplanes are there, machineries are there, like that different product also is there. Then this different product we can classify into different groups like final goods and consumption goods and capital goods, like that we can classify into different group. Okay, then if you are taking an example of tea leaves, okay, tea leaves, we can for a person, suppose who is producing tea leaves, for that person it is final goods. But when we are making tea, drinkable tea, then we are consuming one more time, then what is the final goods? For final good is tea, okay, like that. Different product, if we are using one more time, then it is intermediate good, okay. If you are taking an example of wheat, okay, wheat is the, for some people wheat is final product, okay. Then who are making roti or chapati, for them it is intermediate goods, means they are buying that product and they are transforming into chapati or roti, then it is intermediate goods, okay. Then final goods means, in final goods means it will not pass through any more stages of production, means final use. Final goods means final use and will not pass through any more stages of production, production or transformation. Then final goods means those goods which use either for final consumption or for investment, that one we are calling as final goods, okay. Then what is consumption goods? Those final goods which satisfy human wants directly, example ice cream, clothing, all the goods that produced in economy we can called as means for which are using for our consumption, we can call as consumption goods. Milk, or if you are making tea, that tea also consumption good, okay. Pen, paper, all these items, bag, dress, everything consumption goods, okay. Then what is capital goods? Those final goods which help in production, means some goods which help in production we can call as capital goods, okay. These goods are used for generating income. Capital goods means these goods are using for generating income. These goods are fixed asset of the producers, example plant and machinery. Means plant means for a company or for a firm, we know machineries will be there, that plant will be there, that one will be asset for the producers, this one we are calling as capital goods, okay. Then capital goods will be there, then consumption goods are there, then final goods are there, intermediate goods are there, okay. Goods like food and clothing and services like recreation are consumed by the consumers are called as consumer goods, okay. Then now we can go through consumer durables, okay. If you are taking an example of TV, TV is a consumer durable, means it that product we are using for a long time, like that products we are calling as consumer goods, okay. What is capital goods? Means for making, suppose we know we want machineries for producing a car, we need lot of machineries, or like that we need a company, industry, like that we need so much machineries, tools, these items we can call as capital goods, okay. Then commodities like television set or car or computer, like that items have ultimate consumption and they have characteristic of capital goods. They are also durable and that one we are using for a longer time, okay. Then these products are going under the wear and tear with gradual use. We know continuously when we are using a car, it will go under the wear and tear, okay. Then we need to repair and replacement some parts. Machineries also we need to replace and we need to repair the parts, okay. Then like these goods we are calling as consumer durables, means these products are going under the wear and tear, that reason we are calling it as consumer durables, okay. Then next one, we studied intermediate goods. Example for intermediate good, here it is there, steel sheet used for making automobiles and copper used for making utensils. Okay, these are intermediate goods. Sheet is not a final good, that one is intermediate good. It's going for one more stage of production, and final good is copper vessel or car or like that items. Okay, then that one is intermediate goods. Final good is that copper vessel. Okay, that one is the final goods. Okay, next, then final goods are those goods which are used either for final consumption or investment. That one we are calling as final goods. Next one is intermediate goods. Intermediate goods refers to those goods and service which are used as a raw material for further production for resale in the same year. Okay, means same year we are using for further production. These goods do not fulfill needs of mankind directly. Okay, that one is intermediate goods. Okay, then what is investment? Investment means it is a addition made to the physical stock of capital. We studied what is capital. It is a addition to the physical stock of capital during a period of time. It is called investment. Okay, then addition to the physical stock of capital we are calling as investment. It is also called as capital formation. Okay, then this addition we are calling as capital formation. Okay, then next one, capital formation. Change in the stock of capital is also called as capital formation. Means change, we studied addition to the capital. Then what is happening there? Change is coming to the stock of capital. That one we are calling as capital formation. Next one is depreciation. Depreciation means fall in value of fixed capital goods due to normal wear and tear and expected to obsolescence. Okay, then we know all the products are going under the wear and tear. Okay, means suppose we are buying a car now, then price is 5 lakhs. After 5 years, price will reduce to 1 lakh or 2 lakh because some wear and tear is there. Because of that reason, the value is coming less. Okay, value is decreasing. Okay, then depreciation means fall in value of fixed capital goods due to normal wear and tear. It is also called consumption of fixed capital. Consumption of fixed capital. Okay, then depreciation means fall in the value. If you are taking another example, like TV, if you are buying a TV now, after 5 years, if when we are selling that product, we will get only if we are buying for 50,000, after 5 years we will get only 1,000 rupees or 5,000 rupees because of depreciation, fall in the value of that goods. Okay, that one is depreciation. Next one is gross investment. Total addition made to physical stock of capital during a period of time. Okay, gross investment means total addition, total how much we added the stock of capital, that one we are calling as gross investment. Okay, total addition made to physical stock of capital during a period of time we are calling as gross investment. It includes depreciation or net investment plus depreciation. It includes depreciation or net investment plus depreciation. Okay, next one, net investment. Net investment means net addition made to the real stock of capital during a period of time. Okay, net investment means net addition to the real stock of capital during a period of time. Net investment equal to gross investment minus depreciation. Okay, Then net investment equal to gross. We know what is gross investment. Gross investment minus depreciation we can call as net investment.